MPC machine comes equipped with a full step sequencer. Step sequencers are a fun way to input your beats. Another reason why you might want to use the step sequencer for some devices on Android is the fact that some devices suffer from latency. That is, when you press the pad, there's a delay from when you press it to when you hear the sound. The step sequencer is a great way to input your beats without having to deal with that latency issue. So what we're going to try and do here, we're going to start with an empty sequence. To do that, press any pad, then press the option 2 button, then put delete sequence for the full range. I'm using the house and garage kit that comes with MPC Machine 1.07. You can use any kit that you want to use. Once you've got a drum kit that you're happy with, press the menu button and then access the step sequencer. We want to make sure that we're looping just for one bar for this tutorial. You can loop as many bars as you want, but to keep it simple, we're going to just loop one bar. So make sure that you're at the start of the sequence. To do that, hold on any pad and press the cursor left button. And now press the cursor up button. So you're just looping one bar. You'll see it says L1, L2. Press play. You'll see that it'll just loop 16 steps to that bar. If you see the red bar, it will only go to that range there. To navigate through the sounds of your drum kit, use the cursor keys up, right, left and down to change the currently selected pad. The kick drum for this kick is in the bottom left hand corner, pad number 1. And that's what I'm going to start with. Now, in order to play the pattern on this kick drum, all you need to do is light up the pads in the positions where you'd like the sound to play. So wherever that green light intersects one of those yellow pads, it will play a sound and it will turn red. So if I was to tap some pads over here, see that? I'm just messing around. Or I can take it off, tap them again to remove them. Okay, and we can select another sound by using the cursor arrows. I'm going to select a snare sound, which is right next to my kick. I'm going to use a close hi-hat next.
I want my hi-hat to play on 16. That means there's going to be 16 pads lit up, because there's 16 steps or pads to one bar.
And then this open hi-hat. Okay, not too much. Just take that. Always a clap sound there. Just that. As long as you remember to use the cursor keys to select the sound that you want. You can always go back to the sound you've previously recorded and change things. So there's the pattern for the kick drum. There's the pattern for the snare. There's the pattern for the hi-hat. So wherever the square's on, selected, you'll see the pattern that we currently have. So for this clap, we don't have anything. Once you've created a drum groove that you're satisfied with, press the option 1 button to exit the step sequencer. This puts us back in the normal drum machine mode. And here you can add and record as normal. For example, I'm going to change that those 16 hi-hats and add some more swing to them. If you don't know how to do this, look at the tutorial on real-time swing. But for this example, I'm going to show you. Hold down the pad, which customers' cases, HSCLHH. Number three, and then press the cursor up button while doing it. Put some nice bit of swivel to it. And that's really how you make a beat in the step sequencer. It's quite fast, quite simple to use. Great for devices that suffer with latency. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you for watching this tutorial.